de man uit zijn Dartsmaster van 2012, The Wizard, Simon tegenstander, een man die bezig is aan zijn 70ste Eurotour toernooi. Hij won er al 6. De UK Open kampioen van 2017. Het feest kan beginnen. Hij is binnen. Snakebite. Pieter Wright.
Helsinki, Finland. I know what y'all thinking that you can outthink me, but you can't, frankly. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Get on party like it's don't stop the party. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Get on party like it's don't stop the party. I'ma give it to you, now give it to me, I'ma give it to you, now give it to me,
still not going to get used to that DJ. It is the ridiculous hairdo derby here in the Dutch Darts Masters as the Wizard takes on Snakebite in the penultimate game of the afternoon session. We have three quarterfinals set up here at the Dutch Darts Masters. Michael van Gerwen takes on Dave Chisnell. Glenn Durrant is up against Gerwin Price. What a half of the draw that is. Ian White, looking to make a fourth consecutive Euro Tour final, will face another Dutchman in Vincent van der Voort. And one of these two will take on either the King, Mervyn King, or Roby John Rodriguez, RJ Rod, who, if he does win this title, is not just going to get £25,000 in ranking money and the prestige of winning a Euro Tour and making the European Championship and probably the Grand Slam. Rob Malarkey is here to tell us what else Roby John Rodriguez is going to get.
Roby John Rodriguez, if he wins...
First leg, Peter to throw first. Game on.
If he wins this tournament, Roby John Rodriguez will be presented with a cow.
A cow?
A cow.
A cow, yes. A real-life cow?
A real-life cow.
Why?
It's the Alpine 16, tradition. It is an Alpine
thank
tradition.
You. Come on, Simon! Thank you.
Right. Okay, well, we have some very delineated caps here in Zwolle. And and we've still got the Vincent van der Voort fan. I think there's some overlap. The Venn diagram of Wright and Whitlock fans evidently doesn't overlap, but Vincent van der Voort encompasses them all.
Yeah, that plea for calm from George Noble fell on deaf ears.
100.
Well, I ain't calm, Rob, it's just sense. Come on.
Luckily for RJ Rod, by the way, he knows somebody who's a farmer, so he doesn't have to look after this cow.
Right, okay.
96.
I still think there are questions here that are raised by this revelation that you have brought us.
Well, one other question is the fact that he's been sticking to a very rigid routine. He's quite a superstitious character,
92.
It turns out, is Roby John. And he's been eating steak every night. And he's
well, the cow's not going to like that.
Well, the cow's not going to like that, but there is an element of irony. The fact that this weekend he's been eating steaks and it's serving him well so far, and he's sticking with it, and yet he may well end up receiving 60. A cow.
So many require
who I hope doesn't immediately turn into a steak on the back of that.
Another one in there. Not to be.
105. Pedro Quire, 150.
He's got options here, Peter Wright. Typically, most players will go on the treble 20s, first dart at least. But he's looking downstairs, I think, for the 19s.
Tommy requires 65.
Well, there's a five. And that leaves tops. And the Whitlock step is employed. And employed to good effect as well, as Simon Whitlock breaks Snakebite's throw to take the opening leg. Now, he was superb yesterday, and he needed to be against the very impressive German debutant Florian Hempel. It seems that Simon Whitlock is destined to play, be involved in matches with quite magnificently coiffured opponents. Because Florian Hempel, the bouffanted German former handball player, was really, really good. He was beaten 6-3, but Whitlock needed every single point of that 103.5 average to overcome him. Now he faces Peter Snakebite Wright. It could be Roby John Rodriguez in the quarterfinals. I mean, this is either a barber's dream or a barber's nightmare, this little section of the draw.
Yeah, he had to work hard yesterday, though, because Hempel, having broken back to get level at 3-3, then missed a dart at double 16 to go 4-3 up, and then Hempel missed a bullseye to again draw level in leg 8. So he was 5-3 down, but he could so easily have been 5-3 up had he finished off those two particular 64. Opportunities. As it was, Whitlock relieved to come through at the expense of the 29-year-old from Cologne. 103.5 the average, as you say, and 6 out of 12 on his doubles. He's had a bit of a brief hiatus on the European Tour. He missed or didn't qualify for the last two European Tour events. Made the final at the German Darts Grand Prix. He didn't enter the tournament in Hildesheim earlier this year.
Yeah, I think he's out in the Philippines playing in a tournament over there.
85.
Actually, prior to that win yesterday, his most recent win on the European Tour was his semi-final win prior to losing to Michael van Gerwen in the final in the German Darts Grand Prix in Munich.
Yeah, beat Max Hoppe in that one, survived match darts to do it, but another Euro Tour final, something he did last year. And Whitlock has left himself double 13. It's something he does leave on occasion, and he's quite happy to pin it.
Simon Whitlock.
And a 15 darter and a 16 darter in the opening two legs for the Wizard. And he finds himself 2-0 up.
Yeah, Whitlock does this thing when he's on 68, for example. He goes treble 14, double 13. I've seen him do that many times. Nobody else does that, as far as I'm aware. He does like double 13.
Yeah, and he does practice all the doubles. I know that might sound weird. They're professional dart players. You'd think they'd practice everything on the board, but it's just not the case. They tend to focus on the things they use more, but Simon Whitlock makes a point of practicing every single double, and that's why he does go some odd routes. You watch, if he leaves himself 78, almost everybody goes treble 18 for double 12, but the Wizard quite likes treble 20 for double 9, which can cause him problems and has done in the past. We'll see if he's employing that route today.
96.
Simon Whitlock, the winner of the very first edition of this tournament in 2012. We can talk about this now because 42. He's not in the room. It was Paul Nicholson he beat in the final that year, 6-1. That was when it was held in Newland. It's been around the block as this 43. Tournament in terms of its location. This is its second visit to Zwolle. Veldhoven held a couple of these. Venray also held a couple. Maastricht in 2017.
60.
Just the 60 from Snakebite, but he's got a bit of a cushion in this leg. Whitlock's just taking his foot off the accelerator, but it might be back on. Might be back on here. Right back on it. First maximum of the match. And Whitlock has beaten Peter Wright the last couple of times they've played, both on big 60. Stages as well.
Simon, you require
one. The European Championship back end of last year, and then the Grand Slam of Darts the following month, only about 2.5 weeks later. Needs to avoid that dart in the treble 20, and 100. Does do. Keeps it nice and high.
142.
Took out a 1-3-8 checkout yesterday, Peter Wright, in beating Richie Edhouse. But the 1-4-2 is not going to go. And it's
92.
Just
Simon,
a bit laboured at the minute. I mean, he's 18 darts thrown. He's not even had a dart at double yet, Peter Wright.
Double 10 then for Whitlock for 3-0.
30. Peter requires
huge let-off. That was for a double break of throw and a 3-0 lead. Peter Wright could well turn this game around and start throwing far better stuff, but he needs to see this off, and
it
does do.
Third leg, Peter Wright. For Rick Simon to throw first.
Well, he still has that break. It's a holder throw for Peter Wright, but it could have been very, very damaging indeed 100. Had Whitlock found that double break. That's it again, Dan.
Well, it spurred Peter Wright into life.
Yeah, a round of applause from his other half, Joe.
98.
Ah, now then. Now then, Snakey.
Oh. 135.
Well, he wasn't aiming there, I can tell you. He would have been looking right down the middle between those two goalposts that he directed.
99.
It took him a 21 darter to get that last leg on the board. Otherwise, he would have been 3-0 down. And then all of a sudden, he's gone five perfect darts in this leg, looking good to break the throw.
50.
Or at least he was. But maybe not so much now. Maybe not so much now.
Easy, Peter, 136.
Terrific timing from Simon Whitlock, making his move at just the right moment.
Simon, you require 24.
You missed three darts in the last leg. Wizard. And three more misses there allow Peter Wright a chance 36. To level this game, a chance that maybe he did not expect to have 15 seconds ago.
Oh, he's inside on double nine.
No score.
And he's busted his score to go all the way back to 36 if he gets the chance. Simon Whitlock blowing the hands.
Well, you practice all the doubles, Simon.
How's your double three? How's your double one?
Four. PD requires 36.
Well, this is just beginning to eat away at Simon Whitlock. This is a massive source of frustration for him. Because he could so easily have been, well, you could so easily have been 4-0 up. As it is, it's two apiece.
Well,
could have been, to throw first.
Really should have been. Three clear darts at 40, missed tops and tens. Three clear darts at 24, missed 12 and 6. And even then he was allowed back to try and polish off the remaining six. But the number 11 seed and former 60. European champion, Simon Whitlock, has just offered Peter Wright a golden ticket back into 59. This match.
Yeah, and he was also a finalist at last year's European Championship. Two times a finalist on the Euro Tour last year, as well as that final earlier this year. He does
100.
Have a lot of European pedigree, does Simon Whitlock.
Well, the Euro Tour really used to be where he did his best stuff. Enormously popular player. That sort of fans' favourite mantle has now passed to Peter Wright. When it really was Simon Whitlock in the early days of the European Tour. But this is their 27th meeting, these two. Never has Simon Whitlock managed to win three games in a row against Peter Wright. And yet, if he wins this one, and he should be 4-0 up in this, it would be a third consecutive victory for him.
Ninety-seven. 134.
They've got a fairly expansive repertoire, this lot. 104 for Peter Wright. Single 18 leaves double 16. And a 104 checkout, and everything just seems to be coming together for Peter Wright after all those reprieves earlier on.
Well, if Peter Wright has suddenly settled, and that was a very Peter Wright leg, 15 darter, 104 checkout. If he has settled now and starts playing properly, then Simon Whitlock is in trouble, because he should have been 3-1 or 4-0 up in this game. And Peter Wright is growing in confidence now. He has had a huge let off, and he might be about to punish the wizard.
59.
Still looking for a first title this year. Peter Wright came so close to winning the last Euro Tour against Ian White. Missed his opportunity late in that game to sneak it away and pick up what would have been a seventh European Tour title. He is the second most successful player on this circuit, behind, of course, MVG.
Yeah, he's without a title of any description since September of last year with that Pro Tour success that he had. One of three titles he won last year. He also won the Melbourne Masters and another Pro Tour event in the summer when he beat Rob Cross in the final of one of those.
Yeah, but no Euro Tours, which is certainly a big change from the years that preceded it.
Yeah, the start of 2017 was very productive for him as well.
A
couple of finals at the start of 2018 for him.
Double 10 for 4-2. And Peter Wright.
Peter Wright.
2-0 down. Should have been 4-0 down. But now finds himself 4-2 up. And he chunters away to himself because he isn't happy with how he's playing. But he must be absolutely ecstatic at the position he finds himself in.
Well, he must be. I mean, there's no two ways about that, because he'll know that this could have been a very, very different situation.
86.
Yeah, 60. Five European Tour titles for Peter Wright in 2017. Three of the first four that year. He was out of the traps very quickly.
Yeah, he was incredible that year.
But he's not won a Euro Tour title now since Lisa that year. So that's almost 2 years ago now.
Yeah, and look, much has been made of Peter Wright. He's had in his form over the last
60.
Year, 18 months. But after the greatest year of his career, and one of the greatest years we've seen from anybody in PDC darts in 2017, was always going to be a tough one to live up to. But 60. It wasn't without its high points. And we should remember, he made the Grand Prix final last year, and he was better than Van Gerwen for the first four sets, and it was only 2-2. Van Gerwen was clinging on. Peter Wright could have been 4-0 up in that game, and I don't think he would have lost that final from that position had he been so. And Peter Wright, we could be talking about him being a reigning major champion right now. But it didn't happen. The Premier League has been poor, but I think part of that has been overshadowed.
55.
Or at least he had a distraction in that his wife Jo's gladly fully recovered from back problems and the surgery she had. That was all going on during it. That's got to have been a distraction. Another one in there. Peter Wright does not spin the 156, but he is going to come back. And Simon Whitlock has just—he's just gone missing. Send out the search party. He's not hard to recognise, but where's he gone? About 6 foot four with dreadlocks and a big beard. Find him.
Double four for a 5-2 lead.
14.
Whitlock, though, has given himself at least a shot at this. It's an almighty big shot, and it's the wrong side of the wire. And this just about sums up his afternoon so far.
Pity require four.
Oh, Where's he go there?
Two.
There seems to be a lot of obstacles in the way of that double two, but and he's ended up in the madhouse, and Whitlock may just sneak this one. Can't find the treble 20.
40.
Well, the trebles have just proved so elusive for Whitlock over the last
two,
well, three, four legs maybe.
He is averaging more than 20 points less than his average yesterday, Simon Whitlock. And he finds himself 5-2 down. And the wizard must be wondering how this has all gone so horribly wrong.
140.
Yeah, the fact that Peter Wright was able to miss six darts at a double before finishing the job tells you the trouble that Simon Whitlock was in that previous leg.
Really is chalk and cheese, this game, from their performances yesterday. Whitlock involved in a real high-quality battle with the little-known Florian Hempel, 103.5 average, and won it 6-3. Peter Wright averaged 98.5 in a really good contest with Richie Edhouse, that finished 6-4 to Snakebite. But here, it's an 85 average, plays an 82 average. And it's not all been lots of misses at doubles. There's just been poor play in various bits of the legs. The scoring phase, the setups, the finishing.
59.
It's just not happened. But Peter Wright has been less bad than the wizard over the last five legs.
94.
Well, five legs without reply for Peter Wright. He may well see that run ended in this one.
100. Simon, you require 76.
Simon Whitlock should get a dart at double here. And he does. It's at double 18.
He's on the eighth leg.
And
Simon
he has
Whitlock.
Stopped the rot. He's got one leg back on the board. 5-3 now after those five without reply for Peter Wright. But Peter Wright throwing first here for a 6-3 win and a passage into the quarters once again.
Well, his scoring has been so poor, Simon Whitlock. That's his first dart at double for four legs. It's the sort of game where anything could happen. You can't rule out a Simon Whitlock comeback here because it's not as if Peter Wright is dominating. Whitlock only has to raise by a relatively small margin and all of a sudden he's on top.
Yeah, and if Peter Wright has many more visits like that, then Whitlock has got every chance. Well, I suppose every player, if they are to have a deep run, is entitled to maybe at least one scruffy performance, and I think this is definitely going to be this one for Peter Wright if he does indeed come through, because there are just one or two signs of life maybe from Simon Whitlock all of a sudden here.
A third maximum for the Wizards.
100.
He's stolen the darts. I mean, when Michael van Gerwen won this title last year, he called it his worst ever tournament win. He should have been beaten
100
a couple of times, to be honest. Daryl Gurney was all over him and threw away his lead in the semi-finals. He was fortunate to come through some of his other ties, but ultimately, it was 65. His name on the trophy once again.
37.
Well, Whitlock in pole position to break. Things might just begin, or are beginning to get a little bit testing here for Peter Wright.
95.
Important last dart leaves him on a two-dart checkout. Whitlock should get a dart for 5-4. He's gone tops. The downside is you block a bit of the bed, but not that bit on the right. Oh,
60.
Not that bit, Simon.
100.
So, Peter Wright, two darts away. And now just one dart away from a place in the quarterfinals on the European Tour once again. And I think you call that winning ugly. That was far from impressive stuff from these two players. But it's the number six seed, Peter Wright, who does advance to the last eight, where he will meet either Mervyn King or Roby John Rodriguez. The average in the mid-80s, the finishing wasn't there either, but he's got the job done, and I think Peter Wright would be the first to acknowledge that as well. Snakebite through Whitlock on his way home.
Peter, I guess a win is a win, but I'm sure you're not very happy with how you played there.
I guess Simon won't be as well. We both played absolutely terrible. I'll tell you what, you guys have played better than we did. Can't explain it. Practice was going amazing. Got up here and it's just like, I could reach as if it was felt like this high.
Is it also a question that this afternoon is completely different than tonight? Tonight it could all click and it could be 110 average?
Exactly. Yeah, now I'm feeling really good mentally and everything, but like something like playing like that, that's probably the worst game I've ever played. But I'm still in the tournament.
Exactly, and you've got a few hours to prepare for your next match. Dames en heren, vanavond is hij terug. Snakebite, Peter Wright. En tegen wie?